Hello everyone, welcome to New Weiming Law Group's YouTube channel. Today our topic is how to complete this important new form, I-944, for my green card application. This new form, based on Section 212A4 of the Immigration and Nationality Act, it's for declaration of self-sufficiency and determination of whether an individual is inadmissible based on the public charge ground. We will first discuss some general factors surrounding the issue of public charge, and then go through the I-944 form in detail. First, timeline. Starting February 24, 2020, most I-485 applicants in both family-based immigration and employment-based immigration, including both primary applicants and their dependents who also apply, will need to complete and submit the I-944 form. The good news is, USCIS will not consider welfares received before that date, such as food stamp, Medicaid, or public housing, and will not consider negative factors for public charge, such as receiving cash benefits from the US federal government, before that date. Again, the date is February 24th, 2020. Even though the date printed on the I-944 form says October 15th, 2019. Why? Because of litigation and court battles that we will not discuss in detail here. Just remember the February 24th, 2020 effective date. Second, negative and positive factors for evaluation of public charge. The USCIS will consider factors including the applicant's age, health condition, family condition, assets, financial situation, education, and etc. For example, negative factors include old age beyond retirement, chronic disease, never worked, never graduated from high school, no health insurance, no asset or income, relying on others for support. Positive factors include age between 18 and 61, currently working or attending university, income above federal poverty line, never used welfare in the past, have good credit history, and having support from capable children who have good income. Third, how to avoid I-485 denial due to public charge. For example, if you have been using government welfare, from now on, consider using no more than 12 months total during any 36-month time period. If you use two different forms of welfare in a single month, such as both food stamp and public housing, that will count as receiving welfare for 2 months. Also, if possible, continue to elevate your education level, skill set, income, and assets. The good news is, even if the USCIS finds you are subject to the public charge ground of inadmissibility, there are still ways to respond. Your relative or sponsor, such as your husband, wife, children, or someone else who is willing to help and has the means, may submit a form called I-945 to the USCIS upon request for public charge bond and make payments to support your green card application. The detailed procedure for doing this is still being developed. Fourth, exception. Some public benefits will not be considered by the USCIS when determining the public charge inadmissibility. Those exceptions include, for example, Medicaid for emergency, medical treatments for children under 21, and for women who are pregnant or just gave birth, school-based benefits such as free meals or reduced price meal, benefits you received on behalf of another as a legal guardian, or benefits for your child who was born in the United States. Now let's look at the contents of the I-944 form itself. The form is quite long and there are four major parts that collect substantive information as illustrated below, plus other parts for formality. Part 1 of the form is personal information, including your name, address, date of birth, nationality, place of birth, etc. Part 2 is family status, for the basic information of your household member. Part 3 is about the assets, income, debt, financial status, credit history, and health insurance information of you and your household members, as well as detailed questions on whether you received any public benefits. You may need to provide supporting documents such as tax forms, bank statements, loan documents, credit report, and health insurance files. Part 4 is about your education and skills. If your degrees and diplomas were all received from abroad, you may need translation and evaluation. For skills, you can provide certificates received. For English language skills, you can enter information about courses you attended. If you are retired, enter the retirement year and date. For the rest of the form, Part 5 is for a statement, contact information, and signature. Part 6 is interpreter's information, and Part 7 is information of the person who prepared and completed I-944 form for you. Part 8 is for a signature and interview. Part 9 is for any additional information. That's all for today's talk about public charge and the I-944 form. If you have any additional question, please email to info@nwmlaw.com. Thank you, and we wish you receive your green card soon.